Okay, the first non-parametric statistics test we're going to do is called the sign test. And what the sign test is utilized for is a test for the median. Let's jump right into an example. A meteorologist suggests the median temperature in Jacksonville is 81 degrees Fahrenheit. A sample of 20 such temperatures was recorded at alpha equals 0.01. Is there enough evidence to reject the meteorologist's claim? Okay, so the claim was the median temperature is 81 degrees. That was the claim. And then the question is at alpha equals, what did I just say, 0.01, test the claim. Okay, now, we're given, we recorded 20 temperatures, 20 days there in Jacksonville, and these were the actual recorded temperatures. Okay, so I'm just gonna write them down. So we have 81, 83, 87. Then 78, 73, 81, 93, and 96. Then 79, 80, 84. And then 85, 77, 72. And finally 73 and 80. Okay, so these were the 20 days that we recorded the temperature. And again, the claim is that the median temperature is 81 degrees. Okay? So let's just start the test. The first thing is the median is 81, that's the claim, right? And that's an equal sign, so where's that gonna go, HO or H1? HO, right? Just like normal stuff. The median is equal to 81 degrees. It is not. Okay? So median equals 81 degrees, median not equals 81 degrees. All right, now this thing is called the sign test because what we're gonna look at is plus signs, minus signs, and if there's a tie, we just usually put a little zero. All right, and what I mean by that is we're gonna go through each of these temperatures. If the temperature is the same as the median, you're just gonna put a zero, okay? If it's bigger than the median, such as 83, you're gonna put a plus sign. If the temperature is smaller than the median, you're gonna put a negative sign, okay? And we're gonna count these signs, okay? So, just go through each one of these. If it's a tie, put a zero. If it's higher, put a plus. If it's smaller, put a minus, okay? And I'm just gonna put it on the top right corner. So that one's tied, that's a plus. Maybe I'll just circle these. That's a plus. Is everybody with me? I'm just writing down literally signs, zero, plus or minus. Minus, minus, another zero, two more pluses. Minus, minus, plus, plus. Plus, plus, minus, 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 minus. Okay? All right. So there's a couple of things that I want to know. I want to know, let's open up our book to that page we were just talking about a few minutes ago. And notice what it says under the sign test. It says alpha, one tail, two tail, and then it also says what? N, okay? Now, N here is not sample size, all right? So that's a huge thing. N is not sample size. N is the number of pluses and minuses. So you throw out the zeros, okay? So alpha and one tail, two tail, we're all used to that, but N, we're normally used to thinking in terms of sample size. So that's not what it is in this problem, okay? N is the number of pluses and minuses. All right, so I have to count through here and add up how many pluses and minuses did I have. So go ahead and add that up real fast. And how many pluses and minuses do we have here?
18.
Yeah, 18, because there were 20 total and two of them were zeros, right? So N here is 18. Okay, great. So I have a two-tailed test. Alpha is 0.01 and N is 18. And that allows me to look up my critical value. So step two, your critical value, you literally just look it up in the charts. N is 18, alpha is 0.01, it's a two-tailed test. And what is your critical value? 3. So everybody see that? And that's the end of step two. Okay, so again, the most important thing is N is not 20. We're used to just how many things there are, but N is the number of pluses and minuses. Okay, so throw out the zeros. Okay, great. Moving on to test value. Again, we're in the non-parametric statistics department, so these things look a little bit weird compared to what we're normally used to dealing with. And your test value is the minimum, whichever one's smaller, on the total number of pluses and the total number of minuses, whichever one is smaller, okay? So if I count through here real fast and I count how many pluses we have, go ahead and do that. Do we have 10 pluses? And then count through. If I did everything right, there should be 8 minuses, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Great, 8 minuses, which adds up to our 18. So the smaller is the 8, okay? So you're gonna count the pluses, you're gonna count the minuses, whichever smaller, that is your test value. So my TV is 8, and that ends step 3, okay? Now, in the sign test, which is the sign test is what we're doing today, it's a little bit different from what we're used to. Usually you have a critical value, and if your test value is bigger than your critical value, you reject it, Joe. But that's not the case in this test, okay? So when we move over to step 4, this is what you look for. If your test value is less than or equal to critical value, then you reject HO. Okay, so only if the test value is smaller than or equal to the critical value will you reject HO. In this case, my test value is 8, my critical value is 3. It's definitely not smaller, so I do not reject HO. And then my conclusion, my results, we're not rejecting HO, so we're gonna go with the claim, median is 81 degrees. Okay, this is the sign test. It's a relatively easy test. It's a test for the median. It's a non-parametric test. You go through, look at the pluses and minuses, you count them up. The total number of pluses and minuses will give you your critical value, okay, looking it up in the chart in the book. Whichever one is smaller, the total number of pluses and the total number of minuses, whichever one is smaller, that is your test value. If that test value is smaller than or equal to your critical value, then you would reject HO. Okay? Any questions on that? So we have the sign test, and then we also have the paired sample sign test. You use the paired sample sign test for dependent data, okay? And remember, with the dependent data, it's usually before and after or matched pair data. Okay, so let's do one of those. Okay, in this next example, a researcher wishes to test the effects of a pill on a person's appetite. 12 subjects eat a meal of their choice, and then their caloric intake is measured. The next day, the same subjects take a pill each time before they eat a meal, and then again, a choice of meal is determined, and their caloric intake is measured again. At alpha equals 0.02, can the researcher conclude the pill had an effect on the appetite? Okay, so in this question, at alpha equals 0.02, did pill have effect on appetite? did it change the calories, right? That's the question. Okay, so we have the 12 subjects that did a meal of their choice, measured the calories, then the next day they took a pill and then did a meal of their choice and measured the calories again. Okay, so these are dependents. So we have person one, person two, person three, person four, five, six. And then we have meal one and meal two. Okay, so it should be obvious that this is dependent. It's the same person. All right, let's write these calories. So person one went from 856 to 843. Person two went from 732 to 721. Person three went from 900 to 872. Number four went from 1321 to 1341. Number five, 843 to 805. 642, 531. Seven 738, 740. 1,005 to 900. 888 to 805. 856. And the last few here. 756 to 695. And number 11 was 912878. And finally, the number 12 person, 998914. Okay. All right, so this is called the paired sample sign test. And it's paired sample because it's dependent data, okay, or matched pair data. All right. So when I go to HO, H1, let's go ahead and start the test. Our normal standard position is that the pill didn't have an effect on the appetite, okay? If it did, you're going to have to show me that in the alternative, in the H1, okay? So I'm going to say, in descriptive terms, I'm going to say no effect. Is it EFF? Or, yeah, no effect on appetite. And it does. Okay, so we're talking about this diet pill or whatever they're using. So no effect versus effect. Okay. So, just like before when we looked at data like this, we used to call it D, right? The difference, the before minus after. Here, we're just gonna look at the sign of that. Okay, whether it's plus or minus or zero. So if I did 856 minus 843, that's going to give me some positive value, right? Because 856 is bigger than 843, so my sign is just going to be positive. And that's all we care about. So go ahead and go through all 12 people and just give the sign. The before minus after is positive. The before minus after is positive. Before minus after is negative. Positive. Positive. Negative. Positive. Positive, 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 positive. Okay, that was pretty easy. Is everybody with me on that? You're just looking at the before minus after and putting if it's positive, negative, or zero. Okay? Okay, step two. Go to your critical value chart. My alpha in this problem is 0.02. It's like a two-tailed test because it does have an effect, doesn't have an effect. So look at the two-tailed test. And what is n in this problem? How many pluses and minuses do I have? 12. All 12, right? So use that information. Go to your critical value chart. 0.02, two-tailed, n is 12. And what do you get for your critical value?
1.
1. Okay, and we're done with that. Moving on to the test value. How many pluses did I have? How many minuses did I have?
Two.
What's my test value?
Two.
Two, because it's smaller, right? Everybody with me on that? It's the same. Look at the number of pluses, look at the number of minuses, whichever's smaller, that's your test value. Okay, step four, do I reject or do I not reject in this problem? Reject or not? What is my statement? If your test value is smaller than or equal to your critical value, you reject HO. Is 2 smaller than or equal to 1? No, it's not, right? So do not reject HO. Okay, because 2 is not smaller than or equal to 1. My test value is not smaller than or equal to my critical value. All right, so step 5. Are we saying the pill had an effect on appetite or did not have an effect? Did not have an effect, right? We're going with HO, so no. Okay. This is the paired sample sign test. Non-parametric statistics are kind of weird, right? We're adding pluses and minuses. It's not something that we're used to doing. And they're not as sensitive as all of the statistics tests we've done before. Notice, 10 out of the 12 people, it did have a plus, but it still wasn't enough to reject, okay? So they're not as sensitive. Any questions?